Good morning, everyone. So in the last class, we are trying to discuss with our generic concepts here. So we completed up to the yesterday class here, how we can work on the our generic concepts here. So today we are going to discuss one important concept called lambda expressions here. So using this particular lambda expression here, how we can write the applications as well as the simple programs here. So to understand the lambda expressions here, first what we need to understand here. So what are the syntaxes we need to focus on our lambda expression here. So basically the lambda expression is introduced in our Java 1.8 onwards here. So the generic concepts are introduced from the 1.5 onwards here. Getting the point. So these are the two difference between introduction section, generic concepts as well as lambda expression here. So when we are trying to work with the lambda expressions here, so we are going to have two primary reasons here. So what are the primary reasons we are going to have? And here we are going to have new syntax elements here. Getting the point? Here we are going to understand the new syntax information. So it's going to provide the expense power of our Java language here. Getting the point? So using our lambda expressions here, we are going to understand the new syntax. The syntax will provide the expense power of our language here. So second one, so it's going to provide the lambda expressions here into the new API libraries here. So basically, based on this particular lambda expressions here, we are going to work on the functional interface. So based on the functional interface, we'll try to focus on the internal, the execution of this particular lambda expressions here. Okay, so this is about the basic information about the lambda expression here. And here, so first we need to understand the lambda expression, and later we need to focus on the functional interface. So what exactly the functional interface will have here, right? So basically, the lambda expression is a anonymous method name. So anonymous method name is nothing but, so the lambda expression cannot have any name here. Getting the point? So internally, it's going to implement to runtime here, because we are not going to implement the particular method information. So just we are going to declare the lambda expression with some values here. Like whenever we are trying to define this particular expressions here internally at runtime, the method is going to created with some implementation names here. Okay, so we'll understand here how this particular implementation is going to work. So to provide the implementation, what are the ways we can create this particular expression here, cutting the pen. So now what you are understanding here, so lambda expression is a anonymous method here. Cutting the bus, anonymous method is nothing but, so the method does not have a name here. Okay, and here the particular method is not going to execute by own. Cutting the pen. So basically, whenever we are trying to work with any method, now what we are doing here, so the method is going to have a name. And the method we are going to implement in the class. So with the help of the class name or the object name, so we are going to call the method here. But what about the same method in the lambda expression here? The first one, the method does not have a name, and the method is not going to execute its own. Getting the point? So how exactly it's going to execute here? So with the help of this particular functional interface, cutting the pen, with the help of this particular functional interface, so the method is going to execute here. Again, so we are discussing the interface section. Cutting the pen. So whenever we are discussing the interface section here, we need to understand the implementation also. Cutting the pen. We need to understand the implementation also. So if we focus here, the functional interface, when we are trying to work with the lambda expressions here, again, so we don't have the implementation class. We don't have the name of the implementation class. So basically, when we are trying to work with any interface here, now what we understand here, basically we'll try to check with the implementation class name, and we'll try to implement the interface, and whatever the method we are defining inside the particular interface, so we'll implement those methods here. Right. So this is very important here. When we are trying to work with the functional interface with the lambda expressions here, so again we need to focus here the implementation class also we don't have a name here. So this section will provide the anonymous class. Getting the point? So now, so these are about the information. Lambda expression is going to work on the functional interface. So the functional, when we are trying to work with the functional interface, again we don't have a the implementation class information. So this is nothing but it is a anonymous class. Okay, so first we need to understand the functional interface, because the lambda expression is everything is going to works on the functional interface. So what exactly the functional interface is going to work, right? Basically, functional interface, it contains only one abstract method. Getting the point? The functional interface will contain only one abstract method here. So we can define any defaults method. So this is different. But if you observe, only one abstract method. The simple understand here, previously, so we discussed our multi-threading concepts here. So in that, we are having runnable interface. Now you can see this particular runnable interface is having only one method. So this particular interface, we can call it as a functional interface here. So if you want to define any default method, we can define the default method, but only one abstract method, right? So whenever we are trying to work with a lambda here, so we need to understand the interface. It should be a functional interface, and we need to define the only one method. So that is a abstract method. So if you remove this particular abstract also in the interface section, by default, public and abstract each and every method here. Getting the point? So this is all about the functional interface. Okay. Now if you observe the syntax here. So basically, basic syntax we need to understand about the lambda expression here. And so the lambda operator, or we are going to call it as a arrow operator. Getting the point? So this section of arrow operator is going to divide the two parts of the particular lambda expression here. Right. So this is very important here. This particular array operator is going to define divide the two parts of our lambda expression here. The left side section, cutting the point. This particular left side section is going to provide the method parameter. Cutting the point. The left side section, so it's going to provide the method parameter here. And the right side section, it will provide the lambda body. Getting the point? It will provide the lambda body. So we need to understand here, this is very important. So this section of code is giving lambda body, and so the left side, it is a method parameter. Getting the point? It is a method parameter. So if you observe here, so as I explained here, the lambda expressions are going to work on the based on the functional interface. So whatever the functional interface method having the parameters, getting the point, whatever the functional interface having the method parameter, so we are going to define as a left side parameter section here. So based on this particular parameter, we are going to perform the operation on the right side, that is called lambda body. Getting the point? So this operator is giving the differentiation, like it's trying to divide into the two parts. So the left side section, we will call it as a parameters, and the right side section, we are going to call it as a body. Right. So in the body, we can define the single expressions, or if you want to work with any multiple expressions. Now what we can do, we'll try to work on with the open brace and close brace. So if you are working on the single, we cannot use this particular open brace and close brace. But when we are trying to work with a block of code, we can go for this particular body. Getting the point? Now we'll understand the simple example here, how exactly it is going to work. So if you see carefully here, now public void, so lambda test, I'm trying to work with one method. Getting the point? So inside this particular method, now we need to understand very carefully here. So I'm defining like this. So I'm trying to define like this here. So one second, the ID is not responding. Now, if you see, so this is also our lambda expression here. So this particular method is not taking anything. It's trying to return the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 value. Right. So this particular lambda expression, so it is equivalent to the this particular method here. So now the method is trying to return the double value. The method is trying to return the double value. And the name of the method, so this is called myMeth. The method is not taking any parameters here. Getting the point? The method is not taking any parameters. It's trying to return the this particular value. Getting the point? So it's trying to return the, so these are the section of code. Observe here. Now what we need to understand here. So now you can see, basically this is our lambda expression we defined. And internally, so it's going to work like this. Internally, it is going to work like this here. Now you can see. So if I'm trying to, so now you can understand here, name of the method called myMeth. And here, this section of code we already identified, this is indicating as a parameters. Cutting the pun. So this is indicating as a parameters. And this is the return type here, right? So this section of code we already identified. So after the arrow parameter, like R operator, whatever the code we are going to write, so that we are defining inside this particular lambda body. So whatever we are trying to define here, so that is will work as a return type of the particular lambda expression here. And here we are trying to work with the parameters. So we don't have any parameter. Now you can see the method does not take any parameter, so we are not defining any parameter. Simply we are trying to return the value. Same thing, we are trying to return the value. Cutting the point. So this is the basic syntax we need to understand here whenever we like look into the this particular expressions here. So basically this section that is I'm trying to explain here, we can understand the this is the parameter section. And this is the body of the lambda expression here, right? So whatever we are trying to write here, so this will treat as a body. And with the help of the parameters also, we are going to understand. So let's see, we'll try to work with one more example here. Right, now you can see, so one more I want to define here. This is also, we are not providing any parameter section here. But now, what I'm doing here, with the help of this particular math class, getting the point, with the help of this particular math class, I'm trying to call one method here, random method. Getting the point. So with the help of this particular random method, I'm going to so multiply with 100. Right. So now you can see this particular random method, it will try to give the some random value. So based on this particular random value, we are trying to multiply with 100. So the after multiplying the whatever the result we are going to get, the result we are trying to return from here. Getting the point. So for example, this return will become, so this value, okay? So 14,795. So this particular value we are trying to return from this particular lambda body. Right. So now you can understand here. So one more I want to write here. So at this time, we are trying to define the n here. So at this time, I'm trying to define the n. So what you are understanding here, whenever we are defining this particular lambda expression here, so this is nothing but we are defining one parameter. The method is going to take as a one parameter. Which method here? Because the lambda expressions are going to work, so based on the functional interface. Getting the point. Whenever you are trying to write like this here, the syntax we need to follow the functional interface method parameter. So for example, so here we are having interface called FNC. Okay, so something called functional interface here. And here we are having something called Boolean. So this test method. So this particular test method is expecting one parameter. So carefully we need to understand here. So basically this is our functional interface because we are having only one method. So this is the by default it is public and abstract method, right? Now if you understand here, this test method is expecting one parameter. Now, so I provided one parameter. Getting the point? So I provided one parameter, so that is called n. So with the help of this particular one parameter, now what I'm doing here? So I'm trying to check here, so n modulo of 2. So if it is equals to 0. Cutting the pen. So n modulo of 2, if it is equals to 0. Now what you are understanding here? So this particular expression is going to return true or false here. This particular expression is going to return true or false here. So based on this particular modulo operator, if the value will become 0, so it will return true. Otherwise, it returns false. Now what you are understanding here? So we are trying to pass the one parameter. The body of the lambda expression is trying to return the boolean. Now you can see, so the return type of this particular method boolean, the test method is expecting one parameter. So it is equivalent to the particular method or not. Getting the point? So whenever we are defining this particular lambda expression here, so it needs to satisfy the syntax of this particular method. So whatever the method we are defining in our functional interface, it needs to satisfy here. Getting the point? So these are the basic syntaxes we need to understand the regarding our lambda expressions as well as functional interface. So we already identified the functional interface, and so as I explained here, we can work with the default method in our functional interface here. Okay, let me create an example on this particular functional interface. Okay, now so we'll try to work with the same folder. So what we are trying to work on our previous example here, but here I want to create our package here. First I'm trying to create a package here, the package called com dot so lambda dot expression, right? So this package I'm creating here, and whatever the example we are going to work, so we'll try to work on the inside this particular package here. So first I'm trying to create a interface here. So this is the functional interface I'm trying to create here. My name of the interface I'm trying to create as a my number, and internally I'm trying to work like this here, double dot get value, double dot get value. So after defining this particular functional interface, now what we can do, we can go for the implementation class here, right? Let me create one more class here. Lambda demo. So inside this particular lambda demo, now what I want to understand here, I want to create our my number. So this is our functional interface here. Getting the point? And it is a reference of this particular functional interface, right? And after this, now what I'm trying to write here. So if you observe carefully here, so this is our reference here. So this particular reference, now what I'm doing here, so whatever the lambda expression is trying to return here, the value I'm trying to store into the my number here. Cutting the pen. So this is the value I'm trying to store. And after this, now what I'm trying to write here, because we call our expression, the lambda expression is trying to return the value. Cutting the pen. The particular lambda expression trying to return the value. Now I want to print this particular value. Getting the point? Now I want to print. So what is a message that we can define here? So fixed value here. And here my number dot. So get value. Cutting the pen. So if we want to print the value, we need to call the particular method So which is we define inside our functional interface. Cutting the pen. So basically, if you understand here, this method we declared here, we did not implement this particular method here, right? So but we'll see how this particular value is going to print. And so one more here, my number is equals to, again I'm trying to work for the expression what we discuss as of now. So math class dot random method here, and so multiply with 100. Cutting the pun. So again here also I want to print this particular random value. Here also I want to print the random value. Cutting the pan. So this is about the one random value, and I want to print one more random value. Another random value. Cutting the pan. Now, so let me run the simple example here. Now you can see, so this is all about the fixed value we are getting. 123.45 and random value. Cutting the pen. So basically, whenever we are trying to call this particular math.random, we are going to get some random value for every execution here. Now you can see I call the one more time the same method, but now compared here, the values we are getting different here. So this value is different and this value is different. So if I'm going to run one more time here, so we may get the different values here. Cutting the pen. So we are getting different values here. So this is all about the random method is behavior here. But now we need to focus here. But what you are understanding here, this section of code. Cutting the pen. So this section of code we are defining inside this particular method. This section of code we are defining inside this particular method that is called get value, and we are trying to return after performing this particular expression here. Now this entire code, how it is implemented here. Now you can see we are calling the method here, but this particular method we did not implemented anywhere here. Getting the point? So implementation is nothing but we need a open brace and close brace of this particular method. Getting the point? We need a open brace of this particular method. So the section of code we are going to call it as a implementation. But how this particular method is implemented. So if you observe carefully, whenever we are trying to work for any method, the method is not implemented here. So we'll get an error here. Getting the point. In the previous section, we identified when the particular method is not implemented by the implementation class. So the compiler will give an error here. We need to make the particular class as an abstract, or we need to implement the interface methods here. But now, without implementing here, directly we are calling here. So here, now we can understand here, with the help of this particular interface reference here, we are trying to call the methods here. But how these particular methods are implemented? So because of this particular lambda expressions here, cutting the pen, because of this particular lambda expressions here, so the methods are implemented at runtime here. The methods are going to implement at runtime. And the method does not have a name here. Cutting the point. So this is the simple example on our lambda expressions here. So any questions regarding this particular basic example here? So could you please let me know if anyone having any questions here? Okay, so now understand here, I'm going to work with one more example here. So I'm going to work for the on one more example. Now you can see numeric test. So this is also one more functional interface I'm defining here, and here I'm trying to work for the same information which we already identified, so boolean test int n. Boolean into test n. Okay. So before going to discuss here, I just want to ask one question here. So can I define like this? Can I this particular expression? So can we define or not? I just want to know. So whatever I'm trying to work in the commented section, so could you please answer whether this particular expression is going to work or not? So the line number 13, what I define here, so is going to compile successfully or it's going to give any error. So if it is successful, what is the value we are going to get? So I need an answer about this particular expression here. No. So whether you are understood or not. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So what is the difference between this expression and this expression here? So any difference we are having here? Okay, observe basically, I'm trying to enable this particular commented section. So why I'm getting this error here? Can we see the error message, like why we are getting this error? Observe here. So now you need to read this particular error message here. So cannot convert from string to double. Getting the point. So what we are trying to convert here. So this is a message I am getting here. Type mismatch, cannot convert from string to double. So what is a string here? Or what is a double here? Okay, so that you need to think basically. So what I want to provide the information here, this is our functional interface. So the get value is trying to return the double, cutting the point. Now we are trying to work for the string here. So whatever we define here, this body is going to treat as a string information, not the double data type here. Getting the point. So very important, we need to understand here. So this particular string related code, we cannot return as a double data type because we already identified the get value method. We are trying to return the double data type here. So we need to return the same data type here. If I'm trying to return other data type, so definitely we are going to get an error here because the everything, the section of code we is going to define inside this particular get value method, right? The get value is trying to expecting the return type as a double, but here we are trying to return as a string here. Getting the point. So we are trying to return as a string. Because of this, we are getting an error here. So don't get confused here. So this section of code we are trying to return as a double, and we already identified the random method also returning as a double here. Double. And if I'm trying to perform this particular multiplication, so again we are going to get as a return type as a double, but here we are trying to return as a string here. So this is because of this particular return type, this particular expression is giving an error here. Okay, so back to here, this particular numeric test. Here I am trying to work for the numeric test here. So this is our one method I am defining. So this particular numeric test, we are going to call it as a functional interface. So once I define here, now let me go to the main class here. So lambda demo 2. Getting the point. Here we are going to work for the lambda demo 2. And now we need to think about the return type here. So what is the return type we need to provide? Boolean here. Getting the point. Now understand here how we can work on this particular Boolean data type. This is about the our interface reference here. Cutting the point. Or we can work for the whether is if this particular expression what I am trying to define, whether it is a even expression or odd expression, we need to think about it. So now observe here, if I want to perform so n modulo of 2 equals to 0, so it's giving an error here. Cutting the point, it is giving an error here. So why it is giving an error here? Now we'll understand here. So lambda expression signature does not match the signature of the functional interface. Cutting the point. Now what you are understanding here? So whatever the lambda expression we are defining here, the signature, it is not matching with our functional interface. Now what I need to write here? Getting the point. If it is matched with a functional interface, so what I miss here? Can you please let me know like what I need to define here? So we need to understand here this particular error here. So observe, so this error is providing the information signature does not match with the signature of the functional interface method called test int here. So this particular tester which is expecting here parameter, but here we are not providing the parameter. Now if you see n here, so the error is resolved here. Cutting the point. Now what you are understanding here? So whatever the expression we are defining, so it needs to, the syntax, it needs to match with our functional interface. So this is very important here. Okay, so we define the one expression here. So this is the parameter section and this is the body of the our lambda expression here. Now what we are understanding here by seeing this particular body of the lambda expression here, so based on the n value we are trying to perform the our modulo operator, and whatever the value we are going to get, if it is equals to 0, so though we are trying to return some boolean value. Cutting the point, we are trying to return the boolean value. Okay, now so we define the lambda expression here, but I want to provide the n value here. Getting the point. I want to provide the n value. So how we can provide this particular n value? So if you observe here, I'm trying to work like this here. I'm trying to work like this. So basically here we are going to get, so this is the reference of this particular interface, and with help of this I'm trying to call test method. Sometime like I'm trying to give this particular n value. If it is returning true, now what we can do, we can print this particular 10 is even. Cutting the point. So one more if condition I want to print here. Cutting the point. So is event dot test method. I want to work as a 9 here, cutting the pen. So if it is returning true, 9 also even, right? So this is we can define here. We'll see how many if conditions are going to satisfy here. I'm trying to run the simple application here. Only 10 is even. Cutting the pen. Here now we can see on the console here, we are getting 10 is even here. Right. So this section of code is not printing here. Why? So based on this particular module operator here, we are not getting 0 here. So we are getting other than 0. So whenever we are getting other than 0, this particular test method is returning false here. Because the expression is trying to the expression is returning false here. The same value so is returned by this particular test method here. Okay. Now what I want to do, I want to make not condition here. We identified here, so only one condition is satisfying here. Now if you can see both the conditions are going to satisfy. 9 is not a even number. Okay. Let me run one more time here. Now you can see, so both the println methods are printing here. Now what you are understanding here, so this is very important here, how we are trying to write the lambda expression with the parameters here. So how this particular lambda expression is converting into the functional interface method. So this is also important here. Okay. Now, so one more expression I want to define here. Cutting the pen. I want to define one more expression here. So what is a one more expression? Let me take this particular reference here. I want to change the reference here. Okay. Just for the reference here is on. Okay. Observe here. We already identified here. So we need to work for the one parameter and so the arrow operator, and here I'm trying to work for the our method body, the lambda expression body. Now you can understand here how I'm trying to define it here. So if it is greater than or equals to 0, so we are trying to return the true. Cutting the pen. If it is returning greater than or equals to 0, we are trying to return 0. So otherwise the expression is going to return false here. Okay, now understand here how we are going to work on this particular section of code here. Let's see, we want to call one more time here. If condition, because in the if condition only we can understand whether this particular expression is returning true or false. Is non dot test method. Now what is the value I want to give? So I want to give second. Now we can see, we can define like this. So basically it is not a not negative value, right? It is not a negative. Okay. So same thing, I'm trying to work for the one more parameter. Now you can understand here, I want to find out with the minus one value. So we already identified here the minus one. So it is a negative. Right. Now you can see, I'm going to run the same example one more time. So these two sections we already identified here. Now we need to understand the, so whatever the one value we are giving, it is not a negative, and minus one, it is a negative here, right? So here, whatever the body we are defining, so this is very important here. Getting the point? Whatever the body we are defining, so this is very important we need to understand here. Okay. So this is all about the one more example we discussed with the Boolean return type here. Getting the point? Now you can see, so here we are trying to work for the n here, and So this is also one option we are having. We can define like this, int n. Now you can see int n here. So here we are trying to work for the data type here. Now you can see if I am going to run the same example here, I am getting the same output here. So either like we can go for the declaration section like this, or we can go for the parameter here. Getting the point? We can define. So in any case here, it's going to applicable here. But the problem here, when we are trying to work for the two parameters here. Getting the point? When we are trying to work for the two parameters. So if we observe, so one more. Let me define the one more functional interface here. So numeric test 2. So this is our one more functional interface. And the same method I am trying to take, but here I am defining two parameters here. I am trying to define two parameters. Getting the point? Let me connect with our demo example here. So lambda demo. Our lambda demo 3. And click on finish. So now what I want to write here. So I want to take the reference of this particular interface. So this is our numeric test 2. Inside this particular numeric test 2. So we can define here some expression here. Cutting the pen, some expression here. Now we understood the values here. So n dot t. I'm defining array operator and I'm trying to work for the body here. So this section of body, now what I'm trying to write here. So n modulo of d. So if it is equals to 0, so it will return true, otherwise it will return false. Now understand here. So we are trying to work for the two parameters here. We define the one test method, so which also expecting two parameters, and we are trying to perform one operation here, something called module operator. With the help of this particular module operator, we are doing some operation, and whatever the value we are going to get, so if it is equals to 0, so this particular body of the lambda expression will return true. So otherwise it will return false here. Right. Now understand here. So this is about the lambda expression. I want to work for the with some values here. Now we can understand here. What is the n value? I want to give n value as a 10, and the d value I want to give as a 2. So if it is returning, so if it is, this test method is returning true, now what we can do? We can print this particular message here. Cutting the point, we can print this particular message here. It is a otherwise 2 is a factor of 10. Cutting the point. So basically we are trying to work for the factor related example here. Now I want to define this particular message. Now understand here. So one more expression here. Test here. And what is the value I want to provide here? What is the n value? And I want to give as a 10. Here I want to give as a 3. So now, so same message I'm trying to define here. We'll see whether this particular message will print or not. We need to understand this particular message is going to print or not. Getting the point? Now I'm trying to pass 10, 3, and 10 comma 2. So based on this particular module operator, because we already identified in the initial classes here when we are trying to work for the operator example. So how this particular module operator is going to work, we already identified. Let me run the simple example here. Now you can see, so only the first condition is printing. Only the first condition is printing here. So why the second condition is not printing here? Because of, so n modulo of d, we are not going to get the remainder value 0. So we may get some other than this particular 0. Because of that, we are getting false here. For the second condition, I am making not condition here. Now observe here. So both the values are printing. Getting the point. So this is also important here. If this particular test is returning false, now what we can do? We are making true. If it is returning true, so with help of this particular not operator, we are making the entire expression false here. Getting the point. We already identified that the not operator is going to work. So opposite manner, whatever the value we are getting for the current expression here. Okay, right. Now understand here this particular test section here. That particular test section. Now here we need to understand the parameter values here. Like how we can work on this particular parameter values. So as I explained here, we can define like this. We can define like this. So it's going to work. But the problem here, we cannot provide the one parameter with a data type, one parameter with a value. So you can see, if I'm trying to providing each and every parameter with a data type, so it's not going to get any error. But now, if I'm removing this, so it's giving an error here. We cannot work for the one parameter with a data type and another parameter without a data type here. So this is very important here whenever we are trying to work for the expressions here. So either we need to remove the data type or we need to provide the so data type value here. Okay, so this is all about the our simple example here. Now if you understand here, we are trying to work for the only one line of statement here. Here we are trying to work for the one line of statement. So if I want to work for the multiple lines of code, getting the point. In the body of this particular lambda expression, I want to work for the multiple lines here. So for example, I want to make some conditions. I want to make some switch cases. I want to make some expression like loops concepts here. How we can define here? Getting the point. How we can so work on this particular example here. So let's see. So to understand the block of code, how we can define inside this particular lambda, now I want to define the one more functional interface. The functional interface I am trying to work for the so numeric function I am trying to define here. So inside this particular numeric function here, I am trying to return one integer value and name of the function here fuNC. And which is expecting one parameter. So which is expecting one parameter here. Okay. Now we create the functional interface. Now what I want to do, I want to go for our main class here. So block code demo. Basically here we are trying to work for the block of code here. So instead of defining single line, we are trying to defining multiple lines here. Okay, now you can understand here. So numeric function. So numeric function here. Right. So when we are trying to work for this particular numeric function here, now what I understand here? I'm trying to work for the lambda parameters. So which is expecting one. So one parameter, and here I'm trying to work for the body here. Here I'm trying to work for the body. Whenever we are trying to work for the body, now you can see I'm trying to opening and I'm trying to closing here. cutting the point. I'm trying to opening, I know, I'm trying to close. So after, now what I'm trying to write here, so this is about result here. The result I'm trying to initialize with the one value, and finally I'm trying to work for the loop here. So inside this particular loop, int I is equals to 1, and so I less than or equals to n, carrying the pattern. So whatever the parameter value we are getting here, the parameter value I'm making a condition here. Right. And after this, now what I'm doing here? So result is equals to I multiplication with the result here. I multiplication with the result. And when we're trying to work for the block of code here, so we need to return the value. Result. And we need to close with our body of the lambda expression here. Now what you are understanding here? So based on this particular n value, whatever the n value we are going to specify, so based on the particular n value, we are trying to repeating the loops here, and we are trying to find out the result here. So it's nothing but we are trying to find out the factorial of the given number here. Getting the point? So this particular example is indicating here factorial of the given number. Now, so what is the number I'm trying to give? Now you can understand here, system dot out dot, so println here, inside this particular println I want to provide the factorial of 3. I want to find out the factorial of this particular 3. Fact dot function, I want to provide 3. Right? And later, so I want to work for the 5. Understand here how we are trying to work for the this particular factorial example here with our lambda expressions here. Now I'm trying to run the simple example. So 3 for the 6 and 5. We are getting the factorial value 120. And if we want to understand this particular loop is how many times this loop is repeating here. Now what we can do? Here we can work for the result here. So we can go for the result here. So that we'll understand here how this particular, how many times the loop is repeating here. Now, so see here, 112. The result we are getting finally, 6 here, carrying the pen. So first time we are getting 1, and when we are trying to print the second time also, we are getting 1. For the third time, we are getting 2. So based on this particular 2, the result we are calculating, finally we are getting 3, 6 here. Because the value we given as a 3, the result also is printing 3 times. Now you can see we given as a value 5, the result we are printing 5 times here. Cutting the pen, the value we are printing 5 times. So this is the way the expression body is trying to repeat multiple times here. So when we are trying to work for the this body of the expression here, right? So we can define like this, anything, we can go for the any. So basically, if any the logical question you are trying to work, so try to focus on the lambda expressions. You can define the lambda expression with the like and provide the particular values here. Okay, so any questions regarding this particular body of the lambda expression here?
No.
Okay. So we'll go for the one more example here. Let's see, I want to define the one more functional interface here. Basically, this is a string function. So string functional interface I'm trying to defining it, and this particular method is trying to return string. Name of the method, we can work for the same function, and here I'm trying to work for the parameter also string. The parameter also string. Okay, observe here, I am trying to work for the block code here. The block code demo 2. And internally, now what I'm trying to write here. So I'm trying to work for the reverse. Whatever the string I'm going to give, I want to make the particular string as a reverse here. Getting the point? I want to make the given string reverse order here. So how we can provide here? Getting the point? So how we can work for this particular section of code here? So observe, now what I'm trying to work here, basically we are defined the function name, something called string function. It is a functional interface, and so reverse one variable I'm trying to take for the reference of this particular functional interface. So we already identify, so which is expecting, which is expecting one parameter. So that is I'm defining as a str. With help of this particular str, we are trying to work for the our body of the lambda expression here. Now you can see, so I'm trying to work for the result here. So this is the result is empty. First time the result is empty. Now I'm defining here, int value. The int also I'm trying to take as a, so let me declare here the section of code we can define inside this particular loop. So I is equals to str dot length method, right? So whatever the length we are going to get, so the minus one I'm trying to initialize with the I value. Getting the point? So this is all about the I value, and I want to make the condition I greater than zero. Getting the point? So we'll understand the greater than zero and I minus minus. Getting the point? Now what you are understanding here? So basically the length, for example, if I'm going to get length as a 5 year, now I'm trying to subtract with minus one. So the length we are going to get as a 4. So 4 is nothing but we are trying to find out the last character of the given string. Getting the point? The last character of the given string we are going to get as a I value, right? So based on that, we are trying to repeating the loop by subtracting by decrementing the I value here. So 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Getting the point? So this is the way the I value is going to decrease here. Okay, so we provided information like this, and now I want to work for the result here. So result is equals to str dot. Getting the point? Str dot, we are having one method caret 2. Here I want to provide I value. So based on this particular index here, so whatever the value we are going to have, so the value I'm trying to initialize or storing into this particular result here. I'm storing into this particular result. So finally, I'm trying to return this particular result value. Finally, I'm trying to return this particular result here. Getting the point? So this is very important here. Now, observe here with this particular println statement here, how we can write the lambda string expression here. So lambda reverse here. Now, so what we can do, this is the functional interface reference here. Reverse dot our function. Here I want to provide lambda. Cutting the point. Now understand here, I'm calling the function here with the string here. The string we are going to pass as a str. So we are going to work for the str len, and every time we are loading the character for the which is located in the I value. Now we can understand here. So what is it is missing here? So it is expected the result we are getting here. Some character is missing here. The L is not there here. Getting the point. So why this particular L is not there? Okay, let's see. So I want to debug this particular example here, so to understand here. Now we need to understand the str here. So what is the str value we are getting here? Lambda, right? So str is nothing but this is the str. Getting the point? So this is the str we are getting here, and after this, now what I am doing here, result and loop. Now you can understand here what is I value we are getting. 5. The I value you can see here, we are getting 5 here. Now, so what is the value we are going to have inside this particular I value is nothing but caret method, where the caret method is expecting integer value, so we are passing as a 5. So what exactly the value resides in the particular method here? Now you can understand here A. Getting the point? So this particular last character or not. Now you can see in our str A we are trying to return. The last character is getting. The last character we are trying to initialize into the result variable. Now you can understand here. If I'm back to here, the result we are having A. So as of now we are having A. Now the loop is repeating one more time. Cutting the point. Now what is I value? We are having I value 4. So I value is decreased here. Now we need to understand the I value here. So based on this particular I value, what is the value we are going to get? So D. So D we are getting here. So D is nothing but, so previously we got A, currently we are getting D. Now what you are understanding here? From the right side to left side, we are trying to load the value. Cutting the point. From right side to left side, we are trying to load the value here. Okay. Now, so what you need to understand here? So while loading the value from right side to left side here, why this particular L is missing here? Why this particular L is missing here? So that we need to understand here. Okay. Observe here. So now, the result, now you can see 2 characters are added, so 3 characters are added, and 4 characters are added. Up to now you can see A is added, so D also added, B also added, M also added. Now what is the next character here? So A also is going to add, right? So A added. Now we need to check this particular condition, what it is returning here. Getting the point? Now what is I value? 1. What is I value? 1. And now you can see, so as of now this particular expression is returns true. Getting the point? As of now this particular expression is going to return true. But if you observe, if the I value is decreased here, getting the point? If the I value is going to decreases to 0, so whatever the highlighted condition is going to return true or false. The highlighted condition is going to return true or false if the I value is going to decrease one value. you're not understanding or you're trying to. Yes. So basically, here the problem here. So if the I value is decreased here, the condition is coming out of the loop here. Now you can see I value 0. So this is we need to think very carefully here whenever we are trying to work on any logical questions here. Getting the point. So now you can see if I make 0 like less than or equals to or greater than or equals to 0. Now what happens internally? This particular I value the 0 condition also is going to satisfy and we'll get the particular L character also. Now you can understand here. So result is 0. So try to focus on the result here up to all the characters are added here. Now you can see the final character L is also added here. Now you can see I value 0. Now if the I value become minus 1, so we're coming out of the loop here. So we are coming out of the loop. We are trying to return this particular result. So this is all about our result here. Okay. Now we are trying to coming back to the lambda expression. So the message we are trying to print. So this is all about the return. Any questions? So this is the way we can work for the lambda body when we are having so multiple lines of code here. So still anyone having any questions here? Okay. So this is a basic example we discuss here. Now what we can do, we need to understand the generic functional interfaces here. Getting the point. So as of now, we are not creating the generic functional interfaces here. So these are the normal functional interface we created here. Getting the point. So how we can work for our generic functional interfaces here. Getting the point. Now every data type here, what we are doing here? We are trying to creating one functional interface and we are trying to perform the operations here. But I don't want to create these many functional interface. So I want to create only one generic functional interface so that it's going to work for different data types here. Getting the point. So basically to work for this particular generic functional interface here, now so demo 3. Okay, so basically here now you need to focus on how this particular module operator is going to work here. So this is very important here. So what I want to provide the module operator here, if you see inside this particular module operator, we will work like this here. Right. So whatever the remainder value we are going to get. So this particular remainder value, it's written by our module operator here. Getting the point. Our this particular module operator will return the remainder value. So now you can see 10, 2. Getting the point. 10, 2. Now you can focus on 210 here. So now the value we are getting here 10 and the remainder value we are getting 0 here. Getting the point. So 2, 5, 10 we are getting here and the remainder value we are getting 0. So the 0 is equals to this particular 0. Getting the point. So this entire expression we are getting 0. Right. And we are trying to comparing with the right side 0. Now it's returning true. Now it's returning true. So this particular sum expression we are going to get as a true for this particular condition. For this particular condition, getting the point. So because of this, we are getting this particular message here. So why this particular message is not printing here? If we observe carefully one more time here. So what is the value we are having here? we are having 3 and we are trying to work for the 10 years. Now you can see, so we are going to get 9 years, and here we are getting 1 year. Getting the point? So this particular 1 equals to 0. So what you are understanding here, it's going to return true or false? It's going to return true or false. It will return false here, because both the values are not equal here, because we are trying to work for the double equal to operator here. So this particular double equal to operator, what it will do? It will compare the values, the left side value with the right side value. If the both values are equal, the entire expression will become true. So otherwise it will return false. Now you can see, so here we are getting 1 and we are having 2, 0, sorry. So now, so this expression is returning false here. So if it is returning false here, I make one not condition here. So this particular not condition every time is going to work opposite manner here. So if it is returning true, so it will convert the entire expression will become false. If it is returning false, the entire expression will become true. Now the second example, so it is returning false because both the values are not satisfied. So if it is returning false here, based on this particular not condition, we are making true. Getting the point? So this is the purpose of the particular not operator here. This is the purpose of the particular not operator here. So this is very important, we need to understand about the not operator, because so we are going to write multiple times. So we doesn't know how many times we are going to write. So that much important to this particular not operator here. Only it is simple. If it is returning true, the expression, so it will convert the expression to the false. If it is returning false, the expression, it will convert it into the true. Cutting the point. So because of this, we are printing two expressions here. First one we are getting true. So the second one we are getting false, but explicitly we are making true by using this particular not operator. Okay. So still any questions regarding our lambda 3 example? Okay, so I think I did not see any messages, so I'm expecting all are good. Okay, so back to here. Now what I want to provide here, how we can work for the generic functional interface. Getting the point? So generic functional interface, how we can define here? I'm trying to create one functional interface. The name of the functional interface, some function. Cutting the point. So this particular sum function, I'm trying to work for the T here. Cutting the point. I'm trying to work for the generic format here. And returning T and name method name also I'm trying to define with a function. Parameter also I'm trying to define as a type here. The parameter also I'm trying to define as a type here. Cutting the point. So this is all about the our generic functional interface, because here we are having only one method. So when we are defining one method, we already identified it is a functional interface, but only the advantage we are getting a type manner. So it is nothing but we are converting into the, so this particular generic functional interface is going to support multiple data types here. Okay. Now let me create our main class here. So generic, so function demo, and main method. So inside this particular main method, now what I want to provide the information here, the function is expecting T, the sum function I'm trying to converting as a string. Now the functional interface, we are having a string functional interface. Okay, after this Now what I want to provide here, so the reverse example, maybe I think this is only we implemented, right? I want to copy this particular reverse example. Right. Here, now what I want to write here, so instead of sync function, I want to work for the sum function here. Getting the point? Observe carefully here. So the same reverse I am trying to work here. Getting the point? Now you can see, now what I am trying to write here, the factorial logic here. So this is our numeric function. This is our numeric function. Now you can see the numeric function also I want to use the same function here, sum function. I don't want to use the numeric function integer. Observe carefully here. So we define only one function interface here. Getting the point? We define only one function interface, but we are trying to perform the two data type operations here. We are trying to perform the two data type operation. Now you can see here we are trying to work for the factorial logic here, and we are trying to work for the reverse string here. But here the function is same. Getting the point? So the functional interface same, and the name of the method also same. So instead of defining these many functional interfaces, so as of now we created 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So around 7 functional interfaces we created. But now what you are understanding is, by creating the generic functional interface, getting the point? So we can perform the any data type of the particular operations here. So this is very important. We need to understand the how exactly the functional interface are going to the generic functional interfaces are going to work. Okay, I'm trying to run the same example. Observe here how this particular two operations we are going to get. So this is the reverse lambda expression we are getting here, and these are about the our functional information. These are about the from the factorial logic here. But here we did not change the functional interface information. We are trying to work for the same here, but only what we change here, the data type we change here. Based on the data type, the entire lambda body we changed here. Lambda body we changed here. So based on our requirement, based on our data type, so we can use the generic functional interface. So we can define whatever the expression we want to write here. Getting the point? So any questions regarding this particular generic functional interface? Okay, so we don't have anything here. Now I want to work for the basically, so as of now here, so we are trying to work for the parameter body, lambda body we are defining here. But sometimes what happen here, we need to provide this entire expression, this entire expression as a method parameter. Getting the point? So this entire expression we want to pass as a method parameter. Getting the point? So how we can pass here? So this section of code is going to provide more information. So as of now, what we understand here, so based on the functionality, the lambda functionality, so same thing we are going to applicable to the method parameter. Now you can see, so we'll try to work for the string function here. So this is the functional interface string function, and we'll try to understand how this particular functional interface is going to work. Okay, let me create a one more class here. I want to create a one more class. So the aim, what is the aim of this particular class here? We are going to pass the entire lambda expression as a method parameter. So we are going to pass as a the lambda expression as a parameter. So lambda as parameter. Okay, observe here. Here, what I'm doing here, so I'm creating one inside the main. I cannot write here. So here I want to create a one method. The method is trying to return string data type here, and so name of the method parameter. Okay, name of the method, I'm trying to specify the parameter, and here if you observe, I'm providing the functional interface information. Getting the point? The functional interface reference I'm providing. So one more parameter, something string here. Something string. Getting the point? Return sf dot fc. Yes. Getting the point? Observe carefully here. So the parameter method is expecting here functional interface as a parameter. Getting the point? Functional interface as a parameter, and one more parameter we are defining, so which is expecting string data type here. So based on this particular functional interface reference, we are calling the method here. We are calling the appropriate functional interface method. Okay, so back to here. Now what we can do, so this is all about the method declaration implementation. Now I want to call the method. Getting the point? So how I am going to call the particular method is important here. Getting the point? So for first time here, so I want to define the string here. The message, what is the message we can define inside this particular, so input str here. So simple example, we can define lambda example. Okay, so this I'm going to pass as a input string. Getting the point? I'm going to get as a output string, right? The output string I'm going to get as a OUSTR. So I'm declaring OUSTR is nothing but output. Okay, OU2 we can define, OUTSTR is nothing but output string, right? Now observe here how I'm trying to call parameter method. So sorry, parameter method I'm calling. Here I want to write the functional interface. Getting the point? So how can I write the functional interface? So we already identified here the functional. So if it is taking the functional interface, we can define our lambda expression. Observe carefully here. What happened here? Here I want to define. Now observe. Here I'm trying to define str. I'm trying to define str. So after this, what I'm doing here? Str dot to uppercase. Str dot to uppercase, and here the another this str. Now what I'm doing here? INSTR. So this particular parameter method will return. So that is I'm going to store output str. I'm going to store output str. I'm going to store output str. So if I'm going to print this output str, so what is the value we are going to get? So what is the value we are getting here? So lambda example, but here all the characters are in uppercase. all the characters in uppercase. So where we defined, so this section of code where we defined here, getting the point. So this section of code we defined here, so method parameter. So this is all about the method parameter here. Now what you are understanding here, here we are trying to provide, getting the point, here we are trying to provide the lambda expression as a method parameter. But whenever we are trying to define like this here, so what we need to define, now you can see the parameter method is expecting functional interface type, and here we define the lambda expression. Getting the point? So as I explained here, lambda expressions, so is going to work based on the our functional interface functionality. Okay, so this is the simple example we understood. Now I want to understand the reverse logic. Maybe I think this is only right. Yes, so this is the reverse logic. I want to pass this entire expression as a parameter. Okay, observe here. So this is a one method calling here. I want to define one more method calling here. Parameter. Here, now what we can do? Let me change the parameter. Let me so take as a the first parameter str. Str. Okay. Again, open our method body. Open our lambda method body. Now here, now what we can do? So define the code. So int I. Right. I want to provide the loop here. So I is equals to what we can do. So length minus 1, I greater than or equal to 0, I plus plus, right? Result, so pre increment operator str dot caret method of I. Result. Getting the point? So this is the first parameter, and here I want to provide the second parameter. So what is the second parameter? INSTR. Here I am passing as a INSTR, and here OutSTR. So this particular OutSTR is going to provide the whatever the lambda expression is trying to return the value. Whatever the lambda expression is trying to return the value, and I'm trying to run the application here. So string index out of range 14. So where we are having the, maybe it is a index out of bound exception, the length it is not matching here. Okay. Here we need to, so space is not converting. Range 4. I is equals to what we define the core. Sorry. Here we need to make minus minus. Now you can see lambda example. So this particular lambda example is coming from the, so this out str output string, and this particular lambda example is coming from the, so this particular out str. Now what we need to focus here, for this particular method, the parameter method, we are passing the entire lambda expression as a parameter. The entire lambda expression as a parameter. So this is the second parameter, cutting the pen. So this is the functional interface first parameter, the string is the second parameter. So here also same, the second parameter INSTR we are providing, and here also INSTR is a second parameter. Okay, so this is all about the how we can pass the expressions, the lambda expressions, how we can pass the method parameter here. Okay, so any questions regarding our this particular method parameters? So anyone having any questions? Okay, so we don't have anything here. We are going to stop the class here, and we'll continue tomorrow. So how we can work for the lambdas exceptions here, carrying the pen. After completion of this particular exception, so we'll try to work on the our, so how we can work for the method concepts here. So variable captions, like first we'll check with the how we can work for the variable sections here inside the lambda. So like what type of the variable we can define, so what exactly the scope of this particular variables here, and after this we'll try to work for the method references here. The method reference also is introduced in the 1.8, getting the point. So this section of code also we are going to discuss in our tomorrow class. So once a lambdas example is completed, we'll continue with the collections examples here. Okay, so if you don't have anything here, I'm going to conclude our today class. We'll continue tomorrow. Thank you.